They didn't have to torture me.
Torture?
Apparently, when he tried to leave the store, the clerk tackled him, then locked him in a room before he called.
A room? It was a closet without any windows, no air.
When we arrived, we found him scratching at the door, whimpering.
I'm a claustrophobic!
My sympathies, Mr. Cummings.
I really can't stand being cooped up.
I'm afraid you may have come to the wrong place, Mr. Cummings. take a statement, pictures, prints, the whole...
Oh, okay, Captain.
Yeah?
Claustrophobia. Just another sob story, huh, sir?
Actually, claustrophobia is a very real and legitimate illness.
Dietrich, I really don't have time to talk about it. Now I have to, answer the phone.
I didn't know that.
Sure. Fear of being confined in an enclosed place is just one of many neurotic phobias. There's agoraphobia. Fear of open places. Xenophobia, fear of strangers. Acrophobia, fear of height.
We got a possible burglary in progress on 13th.
Volunteer.
Take Dietrich with you.
Come on, Arthur. We got business.
Okay, we'll pick it up later.
I'd like to.
You know, phobias are sort of a hobby with me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is there a word for the fear of being enclosed in a confined place, but only with certain people?
Not sure. We can talk about it in the car.
Hey, Mrs. Miller.
Hi, Stan. Oh, it's good to see you.
Yeah, you too.
No, thank you.
What you doing here? I mean, well, we don't get much of a chance to see you, you know, since,
Since Barney and I separated.
So that must be the reason.
Yeah. Well, we meet from time to time, by virtue of our joint checking account.
I'll go
is
get
Barney...
Barney.
Thanks.
Guess who's here?
My wife.
You were expecting her?
Yeah. That's why you got the suit.
What is this preoccupation with my wardrobe? Can't a man get a new suit once in a while?
Sorry.
Hi.
Hi.
How have you been?
Fine. Thanks. That new suit?
Sure is.
It's, very...
All right, come on, Perry, inside here.
Okay, I'm going.
Oh, hi, Liz.
Hi, Rob.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How have you been?
Just fine.
I've been okay.
I haven't been seeing much of you.
Well, thank you for noticing.
Yeah. Oh, I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Oh, no. I wait in the office. Excuse me.
Of course.
It's great to see you again.
Oh, it's great to see you
again. I'll be in a minute. What do we got?
Oh, it's great to see
you
again.
Now?
Barn, this is Clyde Perry. I caught him ripping off the Perfecto Toy Company.
Got the loot?
Yeah, got himself quite a haul. A boomerang, a race car, cute little doll, a yo-yo.
I'm really just a big kid.
And this, which I haven't given a name to yet.
Looks like someone's insides.
No signs of a struggle.
It's dark. I didn't know what I was picking up.
Where's Dietrich?
He's bringing the owner down.
All right, tag all that stuff and do something with that.
Perry, come on, take a seat over here.
Come on, can't you give me a break? Otherwise, I'm going to be spending Christmas in jail.
Hey, where you spend it doesn't matter. It's who you're with.
$420, the Greenwich Hotel.
Rent, 3 weeks.
Rent.
Small room.
Mm-hmm.
Single bed.
I see.
Better than Central Park. Listen, about Christmas morning, what time do you think I should come by?
Oh, well, you know David. He'll be up at 5:30.
All right. Maybe I should come Christmas Eve and wait.
Rachel won't be there until 9.
Fine.
Madison's Sporting Goods, $12.
Bullets.
Ah, so bullets.
Listen, I got a call from Mr. Woodman. He wondered why he hadn't heard from us about the cabin.
Oh, I forgot all about that. Well, no, I didn't forget all about that. I just put it out of my mind.
I mean, just natural assumption on his part. I mean, every year, 14 years.
15.
15. Any case, I guess he just took it for granted we'd be taking it again, you know.
Yes, well, of course, he had no way of knowing.
Yeah, so I told him I'd let him know.
Marioni's Cafe, $36.
It's that little Italian place on 23rd Street. $36, dinner for two.
I see.
Me and Inspector Luger. Well, he's had his eyes on me for a long time.
Let me tell you all about the toy business. It's all thieves and cutthroats.
I thought it was mostly elves. Stefan Medling, owner of the company.
Oh, how do you do? I'm Sergeant Harris.
Where is my ooze? You know exactly what I'm talking about. Everybody's after it.
Could you possibly be referring to this?
Oh, thank God, it's safe. Have you any idea how many people would just love to get their hands on it?
I wouldn't even hazard a guess.
It's going to be the hottest item on the market next season. Look how it oozes in and out of your fingers. In and out of your fingers. It is beautiful. And it's completely harmless if swallowed, and it doesn't stain clothes.
It's quite a breakthrough.
You have to run now?
Well, I'm sure you have a lot of work you have to do.
Yeah. Don't worry about that.
About what?
Mr. Woodman. I'll call him. I'll explain the whole situation.
Oh, sure. Right. Well, I'm sure he's not going to have any trouble renting that place.
Oh, no.
It's a lovely place.
Oh, sure. The loft. Stone fireplace.
Yeah.
It's hard to resist.
I know.
Yes. Oh, what is it?
Captain, my... Oh, excuse me, Mrs. Miller.
It's all right.
I don't think we've ever really been introduced. I'm Arthur Dietrich.
Oh, how do you do, Arthur?
Of course, the captain's told us a lot.
What is it, Dietrich?
We'll talk later. I got a lead from the owner of the toy company. It may be a case of industrial espionage.
Uh-huh, yeah. All right, check it out.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry for the interruption.
No, that's okay.
Okay. I'm going now.
Yeah, fine.
I'll be out of here in a second. I'm gone.
You. Pardon me. Suffocating! Mommy! Daddy!
I think you have your hands full.
Let me out!
We'll talk later. Goodbye, everybody. It's nice to see you.
Let me out!
Sir, what should I do?
Let him out!
That makes sense.
Who's that?
It's Mr. Medderling, the father of Ooze.
Ah, yes. Mr. Medderling, I'm Captain Miller. I'd just like to say that we're going to do everything we can to clear this up.
Oh, sure. That's what they told me last year when they stole my sludge.
Sludge?
It's not a pretty story.
In my office.
Oh, Bart. It was, really great to see Liz. It's too bad she couldn't stay longer.
Well, we just had some checks to go over and Christmas plans to finalize, you know.
Ah. Big, turkey dinner with the family, huh?
No, just Christmas morning with the kids.
Oh. You're not gonna stay for dinner?
This is all very silly and stupid.
Here's the rent.
Oh, Berman! So you thought you could get away with it, huh?
My lawyer will be contacting your lawyer.
This is Nathan Berman, owner of the Berman Novelty Company.
Mr. Berman, I'm Captain Miller.
I am completely innocent of anything.
First, you stole my sludge, you
know. Oh, you're crazy.
Whoa, 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 gentlemen, please.
He's talking gibberish, Captain. I know him for 35 years, and he is no longer completely with us.
Oh, listen, okay, Berman,
gentlemen, please, Mr. Berman. Mr. Berman, we're investigating a burglary, and our information has it that you might be able to shed some light on it.
I am a law-abiding merchant. Now, who would want to accuse me of anything like that?
I never said a word, Mr. Berman.
You're not going to take the word of that cheap hoodlum. Well... I had the right to.
The right to steal the sweat and genius of another
man?
What
about my fuzzball?
Oh, I already had one.
And I suppose you already had speed checkers and baby comatose.
So what about Death Race and Mr. Onion?
Hold it. I'm not really concerned about speed checkers or Death Race or baby...
baby comatose.
What we are concerned with is... burglary.
I want him arrested for theft.
And I want him arrested for patent infringement.
Fine. You charge Mr. Medderling. Mr. Medderling will charge you, and it'll all be very nice. Okay, Harris? Mr. Berman, please, this way.
Berman, over here, please.
Dietrich? Mr. Medderling.
Okay, Mr. Berman, you want to take a seat there? I've got to book you.
On what charge?
Grand theft ooze.
Yeah. Finally finished those arrest reports you wanted.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Hey, I was going to make some fresh coffee. You want a cup?
No. It's fine, thank you.
Barney, why don't you come over to my house?
What?
For Christmas dinner.
Come on, Wojo.
I say come on, Wojo. I mean, I'm making an invitation.
You've probably got other plans.
No, I haven't.
Oh.
Listen, I can make a turkey and pick up some beer and it's a lot of good ball games.
Sure, yeah. Sounds nice.
Great.
Hey, You're sure I'm not interrupting anything? I mean, you're usually not without female companionship on such occasions.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, my outlook on that has sort of changed.
Oh?
Yeah, I mean, well, the way my social life used to be, getting in a sack-a-rooney was the main thing. But, there are other things, you know, like, friendship. Just, good feelings between people can be just as satisfying.
It's very wise of you, Roger.
Well, I finally realized that sex wasn't everything. I guess I don't have to tell you that.
I'm going under. I had to do something.
I don't believe you.
Place of birth, please.
You think to hire a thug to rob your competitor is the act of a solvent man?
Eastern Poland.
What happened? I overestimated the 50s craze.
Who didn't?
I have 14,000 hula hoops stacked up like tires.
You want a trade?
For what?
Poker sticks! I have a warehouse full of them.
Forget it. You can't give them away.
How's it going?
I lost interest.
I'm reconsidering.
Problems, gentlemen?
Nothing you can help, Captain.
Mr. Meddling, we're gonna need your signature on this complaint form.
Yes, I know, Captain Miller, but then...
But what?
Mr. Berman has been stuck with 14,000 hula hoops. That's punishment enough.
How about you, Mr. Berman? Are we going to proceed with patent infringement?
Well, with the courts the way they are now, I'd be dead before it comes to trial. And even if I win, what will I get? Poker sticks. Forget it.
Okay, I guess that means both you gentlemen free to go. Mr. Meddling, don't forget your ooze.
Oh, thank you very much.
What about me?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Barn, we got him red-handed.
Oh, come on, it's almost Christmas.
Well, everybody's dropping charges, turn them loose.
Oh, bless you, Captain.
Yeah, yeah.
God bless you. God bless everyone!
All right, come on, let's go, Tiny Tim.
We're back.
Oh, have a nice little walk?
Wonderful.
Good, good. Good.
We've been gone for quite a while.
I made approximately 35 circuits around the block. If you wish, sir, I'll run them over the tombs now.
Tombs?
Bellevue. Oh. Take them over to Bellevue and introduce them around.
Yes, sir.
Bellevue. I am more sick than I am criminal.
Absolutely.
Okay, Cummings, let's go. Oh, Mrs. Miller.
Oh, hi, Levitt.
Hi.
Hello.
I'm the man who was screaming.
Oh, yes. Yes, it's very nice to see you again.
You're very lovely.
Oh, thank you.
Don't mind him, he's crazy. I didn't mean in his opinion. I meant in a general way. You are lovely.
Levitt.
I wasn't trying to move in, sir. Come on, Cummings, that's fine.
Hello.
Hello.
When I got home, I found some more checks.
Oh. Oh, really?
Took me quite a while. But I found them.
Barney? I think I'll go downstairs and check that roster board.
Fine.
Okay, I'm gonna... I'll...
The checks.
Oh, the checks, yes. Here. Another reason that I came back was because I really left in the middle of things.
Well, it was kind of hectic.
Yeah. Oh. I was thinking about the cabin.
Have you changed your mind?
No. I always wanted to take it.
Pretty amusing the way it did that.
Yeah. Will you call Mr. Woodman?
Yes, of course. I know it's just for a few days, and it's really mainly for the kids. And it's not going to solve all the problems.
Now listen, Barney. Let's not start talking and discussing and analyzing things, because every time we do that, we get into trouble. We're just going to go, all right?
Fine.
Fine.
You know the first thing I'm going to do when I get there?
What?
I'm going to start a fire in that big stone fireplace.
Oh, yeah. Well, it does get very cold inside.
Maybe some hot brandy.
Oh, yeah. It's been very snowy up there, too, you know. I do hope the roads are open.
Oh, yeah. I hope they are.
Yes, well, I'll get out the snow chains. Goodbye. Hi, Stan.
Barbara's not. Want some checks. I'm not going to be able to make Christmas dinner.
You're not?
No, we just changed our plans. We're going to take the cabin in Vermont after all.
Oh. Well, that's great.
We'll do it another time.
Sure.
Yeah. Listen, would you like to come by Christmas morning?
Well, hey,
kids,
hey, Barney.
I get the feeling I'm deserting you.
Barney. You know, in the office when I was telling you about friendship and good feelings between people and
yeah,
how it's just as important as...
Yeah.
Well, I didn't mean it.
Morning, morning, morning.
Morning, sir.
Oh, what a day, what a day. There's a snap in the air. You can almost hear it. And gentlemen, it's getting quite Christmassy. I must have passed 5 Santa Clauses on the way over from the hotel. You know, that reminds me of the first time we took David to see Santa Claus over at Macy's. As hard as we tried, we couldn't get him to sit on his lap. Next year we went back, they talked for 45 minutes. Kid had a list that long.
You all right, Barney?
Yeah, fine. Is that a new suit, Bart?
Yeah. Oh, it always puts me in a good mood, too.
Really?
Yeah, and I buy suits all the time. Must give you a real rush.
What do we got here?
Arnold Cummings, male Caucasian, trying to hold up a liquor store in Lexington.
They didn't have to torture me.
Torture?
Apparently, when he tried to leave the store, the clerk tackled him, then locked him in a room before he called.
A room? It was a closet without any windows, no air.
When we arrived, we found him scratching at the door, whimpering.
I'm a claustrophobic!
My sympathies, Mr. Cummings.
I really can't stand being cooped up.
I'm afraid you may have come to the wrong place, Mr. Cummings. Take a statement. Pictures, prints, the whole...
Oh, okay, Captain.
Yeah?
Claustrophobia. Just another sob story, huh, sir?
Actually, claustrophobia is a very real and legitimate illness.
Dietrich, I really don't have time to talk about it. Now I have to, answer the phone.
I didn't know that.
Sure. Fear of being confined in an enclosed place is just one of many neurotic phobias. There's agoraphobia, fear of open places, xenophobia, fear of strangers, acrophobia, fear of height.
We got a possible burglary in progress on 13th.
Volunteer.
Take Dietrich with you.
Come on, Arthur, we got business.
Okay, we'll pick it up later.
I'd like to.
You know, phobias are sort of a hobby with me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is there a word for the fear of being enclosed in a confined place, but only with certain people?
I'm not sure. We can talk about it in the car.
Hey, Mrs. Miller.
Hi, Stan. Oh, it's good to see you.
Yeah, you too.
No, thank you.
What you doing here? I mean, well, we don't get much of a chance to see you, you know, since,
Any case, I guess he just took it for granted we'd be taking it again, you know.
Yes, well, of course, he had no way of knowing.
Yeah, so I told him I'd, let him know.
Marioni's Cafe, $36.
Is that little Italian place on 23rd Street? $36, dinner for two.
I see.
Me and Inspector Luger. Oh, he's had his eyes on me for a long time.
Let me tell you all about the toy business. It's all thieves and cutthroats.
I thought it was mostly elves.
Stefan Medling, owner of the company.
Oh, how do you do? I'm Sergeant Harris.
Where is my ooze? You know exactly what I'm talking about. Everybody's after it.
Could you possibly be referring to this?
Oh, thank God, it's safe. Have you any idea how many people would just love to get their hands on it?
I wouldn't even hazard a guess.
It's going to be the hottest item on the market next season. Look how it oozes in and out of your fingers. In and out of your fingers. It is beautiful. And it's completely harmless if swallowed, and it doesn't stain clothes.
It's quite a breakthrough.
You have to run now?
Well, I'm sure you have a lot of work you have to do.
Listen, don't worry about that.
About what?
Mr. Woodman, I'll call him, I'll explain the whole situation.
Oh, sure, right. Well, I'm sure he's not going to have any trouble renting that place.
Oh, no.
It's a lovely place.
Oh, sure, the loft, stone fireplace.
Yeah.
Hard to resist.
I know.
Yes. Oh, what is it?
Captain, excuse me, Mrs. Miller.
It's all right.
I don't think we've ever really been introduced. I'm Arthur Dietrich.
Oh, how do you do, Arthur?
Of course, the captain's told us a lot.
What is it, Dietrich?
We'll talk later. I got a lead from the owner of the toy company. It may be a case of industrial espionage.
Uh-huh, yeah. All right, check it out.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry for the interruption.
No, it's okay.
Okay. I'm going now.
Yeah, fine.
I'll be out of here in a second. I'm gone.
You. Pardon me. Hey! I want out!
Hold it down, Cummings!
I want out of here!
I'm gonna put the cuffs on!
Let me out!
What's going on here?
Please, I'm suffocating! Mommy! Daddy!
I think you have your hands full.
Let me out!
We'll talk later. Goodbye, everybody. It's nice to see you.
Let me out!
Sir, what should I do?
Let him out!
That makes sense.
Who's that?
It's Mr. Medderling, the father of Ooze.
Ah, yes. Mr. Medderling. I'm Captain Miller. I'd just like to say that we're going to do everything we can to clear this up.
Oh, sure. That's what they told me last year when they stole my sludge.
Sludge?
It's not a pretty story.
In my office.
Oh, Bart. It was really great to see Liz. It's too bad she couldn't stay longer.
Well, we just had some checks to go over and Christmas.
Since Barney and I separated.
So there must be a reason.
Yeah. Well, we meet from time to time by virtue of our joint checking account.
I'll go
is
get Barney.
Thanks.
Guess who's here?
My wife.
You were expecting her?
Yeah.
That's why you got the suit.
What is this preoccupation with my wardrobe? Can't a man get a new suit once in a while?
Sorry.
Hi. How have you been?
Fine. Thanks. That new suit?
Sure is.
It's very...
All right, come on, Perry, inside here.
Okay, I'm going. Oh, hi, Liz.
Hi, Rob.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How have you been?
Just fine. I've been okay.
haven't been seeing much of you.
Well, thank you for noticing.
Yeah. Oh, I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Oh, no. I wait in the office. Excuse me.
Of course.
It's great to see you again.
Oh, it's great to see you
I'll
again.
I'll be in a minute. What do we got?
Boy, it's great to
what
see
do you
her
got
again.
Now?
Barn, this is Clyde Perry. I caught him ripping off the Perfecto Toy Company.
Got the loot?
Yeah, got himself quite a haul. A boomerang, a race car, cute little doll, a yo-yo,
I'm really just a big kid.
And this, which I haven't given a name to yet.
Looks like someone's insides.
No signs of a struggle.
It's dark. I didn't know what I was picking up.
Where's Dietrich?
He's bringing the owner down.
All right, tag all that stuff and do something with that.
Perry, come on, take a seat over here.
Come on, can't you give me a break? Otherwise, I'm going to be spending Christmas in jail.
Hey, where you spend it doesn't matter. It's who you're with.
$420, the Greenwich Hotel.
Rent, 3 weeks.
Rent.
Small room.
Mm-hmm.
Single bed.
I see.
Better than Central Park. Listen, about Christmas morning, what time do you think I should come by?
Oh, well, you know David. He'll be up at 5:30.
All right. Maybe I should come Christmas Eve and wait.
Rachel won't be there until 9.
Fine.
Madison Sporting Goods, $12.
Bullets.
Ah, so bullets.
Listen, I got a call from Mr. Woodman. He wondered why he hadn't heard from us about the cabin.
Oh, I forgot all about that. Well, no, I didn't forget all about that. I just put it out of my mind.
I mean, just natural assumption on his part. I mean, every year, 14 years.
15.
15.
Bet.
Sex wasn't everything. I guess I don't have to tell you that.
I'm going under. I had to do something. I don't believe you.
Place of birth, please.
You think to hire a thug to rob your competitor is the act of a solvent man?
Eastern Poland.
What happened? I overestimated the 50s craze.
Who didn't?
I have 14,000 hula hoops stacked up like tires.
Do you want a trade?
For what?
Cobra sticks. I have a warehouse full of them.
Forget it. You can't give them away.
How's it going?
I lost interest.
I'm reconsidering.
Problems, gentlemen?
Nothing you can help, Captain.
Mr. Meddling, we're going to need your signature on this complaint form.
Yes, I know, Captain Miller, but then...
But what?
Mr. Berman has been stuck with 14,000 hula hoops. That's punishment enough.
How about you, Mr. Berman? Are we going to proceed with patent infringement?
Well, with the courts the way they are now, I'd be dead before it comes to trial. And even if I win, what will I get? Pogo sticks. Forget it.
Okay, I guess that means both you gentlemen free to go. Mr. Meddling, don't forget your ooze.
Oh, thank you very much.
What about me?
Oh, yeah. Oh, Barn, we got him red-handed.
Oh, come on, it's almost Christmas.
Well, everybody's dropping charges, turn them loose.
Oh, bless you, Captain.
Yeah, yeah.
God bless you. God bless everyone.
All right, come on, let's go, Tiny Tim.
We're back.
Oh, have a nice little walk.
Wonderful.
Good, good. Good.
You've been gone for quite a while.
I made approximately 35 circuits around the block. If you wish, sir, I'll run them over the tombs now.
Tombs?
Bellevue. Huh. Take them over to Bellevue and
Introduce him around.
Yes, sir.
Bellevue. I am more sick than I am criminal.
Absolutely.
Okay, Cummings, let's go. Oh, Mrs. Miller.
Oh, hi, Levitt.
Hi.
Hello.
I'm the man who was screaming.
Oh, yes. Yes, it's very nice to see you again.
You're very lovely.
Oh, thank you.
Don't mind him, he's crazy.
I didn't mean in his opinion. I meant in a general way. You are lovely.
Love it.
I wasn't trying to move in, sir. Come on, Cummings, that's fine.
Hello.
Hello.
When I got home, I found some more checks.
Oh. Oh, really?
Took me quite a while. But I found it.
Barney? I think I'll go downstairs and check that roster board.
Fine. Plans to finalize, you know. Ah. Big turkey dinner with the family, huh? No, just Christmas morning with the kids.
Oh. You're not gonna stay for dinner?
This is all very silly and stupid.
Here's the rent.
Oh, Berman! So you thought you could get away with it, eh?
My lawyer will be contacting your lawyer.
This is Nathan Berman, owner of the Berman Novelty Company.
Mr. Berman, I'm Captain Miller.
I am completely innocent of anything.
First you stole my slouch, you know.
Oh, you're all crazy.
Whoa, gentlemen, please.
He's talking gibberish, Captain. I know him for 35 years, and he is no longer completely with us.
Oh, listen, Berman,
Please, Mr. Berman. Mr. Berman, we're investigating a burglary, and our information has it that you might be able to shed some light on it.
I am a law-abiding merchant. Now, who would want to accuse me of anything like that?
I never said a word, Mr. Berman.
You're not going to take the word of that cheap hoodlum. Well, I had a right to.
The right to steal the sweat and genius of another man?
What about my fuzz ball?
Oh, I already had one.
And I suppose you already had speed checkers and baby comatose.
So what about Death Race and Mr. Onion?
Hold it. I'm not really concerned about speed checkers or Death Race or
baby comatose.
What we are concerned with is burglary.
I want him arrested for theft.
And I want him arrested for patent infringement.
Fine. You charge Mr. Meddling. Mr. Meddling will charge you, and it'll all be very nice. Okay, Harris? Mr. Berman, please, this way.
Berman, over here, please.
Dietrich? Mr. Meddling.
Okay, Mr. Berman, you want to take a seat there? I've got to book you.
On what charge?
Grand theft ooze.
Yeah.
Finally finish those arrest reports you wanted.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Hey, I was gonna make some fresh coffee. You want a cup?
No. It's fine, thank you.
Brian, why don't you come over to my house?
What?
For Christmas dinner.
Come on, Wojo.
I say come on, Wojo. I'm making an invitation.
You've probably got other plans.
No, I haven't.
Oh.
Listen, I can make a turkey and pick up some beer and it's a lot of good ball games.
Sure, yeah. Sounds nice.
Great.
You're sure I'm not interrupting anything? I mean, you're usually not without female companionship on such occasions.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, my outlook on that has sort of changed.
Oh?
Yeah, I mean, Well, the way my social life used to be, getting in a sack-a-rooney was the main thing. There are other things, you know, like friendship. Just good feelings between people can be just as satisfying.
It's very wise of you, Roger.
Well, I finally realized.
Morning, morning, morning.
Morning, sir.
Oh, what a day, what a day. There's a snap in the air. You can almost hear it. And gentlemen, it's getting quite Christmassy. I must have passed 5 Santa Clauses on the way over from the hotel. You know, that reminds me of the first time we took David to see Santa Claus over at Macy's. As hard as we tried, we couldn't get him to sit on his lap. Next year we went back, they talked for 45 minutes. Kid had a list that long.
You all right, Barn?
Yeah, fine.
Is that a new suit, Barn?
Yeah.
Oh, it always puts me in a good mood, too.
Really?
Yeah, and I buy suits all the time. Must give you a real rush.
What do we got here?
Arnold Cummings, male Caucasian, trying to hold up a liquor store in Lexington.
They didn't have to torture me.
Torture?
Apparently, when he tried to leave the store, the clerk tackled him, then locked him in a room before he called.
A room? It was a closet without any windows, no air.
When we arrived, we found him scratching at the door, whimpering.
I'm a claustrophobic!
My sympathies, Mr. Cummings.
I really can't stand being cooped up.
I'm afraid you may have come to the wrong place, Mr. Cummings. Take a statement. Pictures, prints, the whole...
Oh, okay, Captain.
Yeah?
Claustrophobia. Just another sob story, huh, sir?
Actually, claustrophobia is a very real and legitimate illness.
Dietrich, I really don't have time to talk about it. Now I have to answer the phone.
I didn't know that.
Sure. Fear of being confined in an enclosed place is just one of many neurotic phobias. There's agoraphobia, fear of open places, xenophobia, fear of strangers, acrophobia, fear of height.
We got a possible burglary in progress on 13th.
Volunteer.
Take Dietrich with you.
Come on, Arthur. We got business.
Okay, we'll pick it up later.
I'd like to.
You know, phobias are sort of a hobby with me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is there a word for the fear of being enclosed in a confined place, but only with certain people?
I'm not sure. We can talk about it in the car.
Hey, Mrs. Miller.
Hi, Stan. Oh, it's good to see you.
Yeah, you too.
No, thank you.
What you doing here? I mean, well, we don't get much of a chance to see you, you know, since...
Since Barney and I separated.
Guess that must be a reason.
Yeah. Well, we meet from time to time, by virtue of our joint checking account. Is Barney... Thanks.
Guess who's here?
My wife.
You were expecting her?
Yeah.
That's why you got the suit. What is this preoccupation with my wardrobe? Can't a man get a new suit once in a while?
Sorry.
Hi.
Hi.
How've you been?
Fine. Thanks. That new suit?
Sure is.
It's very...
All right, come on, Perry, inside here.
Okay, I'm going. Oh, hi, Liz.
Hi, Rob.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How have you been?
Just fine. I've been okay.
Haven't been seeing much of you.
Well, thank you for noticing.
Yeah. Oh, I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Oh, no. I wait in the office. Excuse me.
Of course.
It's great to see you again.
Oh, it's great to see you again.
I'll be in a minute. What do we got?
Oh, it's great to see
you
again. Barn, this is Clyde Perry. I caught him ripping off the Perfecto Toy Company.
Got the loot?
Yeah, got himself quite a haul. A boomerang, a race car, cute little doll, a yo-yo.
I'm really just a big kid.
And, this, which I haven't given a name to yet.
Looks like someone's insides.
No signs of a struggle.
It's dark. I didn't know what I was picking up.
Where's Dietrich?
He's bringing the owner down.
All right, tag all that stuff and do something with that.
Perry, come on, take a seat over here.
Come on, can't you give me a break? Otherwise, I'm going to be spending Christmas in jail.
Hey, where you spend it doesn't matter. It's who you're with.
$420, the Greenwich Hotel.
Rent, 3 weeks.
Rent.
Small room.
Mm-hmm.
Single bed.
I see.
Better than Central Park.
Listen, about Christmas morning, what time do you think I should come by?
Oh, well, you know David. He'll be up at 5:30.
All right. Maybe I should come Christmas Eve and wait.
Rachel won't be there until 9.
Fine.
Madison's Sporting Goods, $12.
Bullets.
Bullets.
Listen, I got a call from Mr. Woodman. He wondered why he hadn't heard from us about the cabin.
Oh, I forgot all about that. Well, no, I didn't forget all about that. I just, put it out of my mind.
It's a natural assumption on his part. I mean, every year, 14 years.
15.
15.
15.
Any case, I guess he just took it for granted we'd be taking it again, you know.
Yes, well, of course, he had no way of knowing.
Yeah, so I told him I'd, let him know.
Marioni's Cafe, $36.
It's that little Italian place on 23rd Street. $36, dinner for two.
I see.
Me and Inspector Luger. Well, he's had his eyes on me for a long time.
Let me tell you all about the toy business. It's all thieves and cutthroats.
I thought it was mostly elves. Stefan Medling, owner of the company.
Oh, how do you do? I'm Sergeant Harris.
Where is my ooze? You know exactly what I'm talking about. Everybody's after it.
Could you possibly be referring to this
Oh, thank God, it's safe. Have you any idea how many people would just love to get their hands on it?
I wouldn't even hazard a guess.
It's going to be the hottest item on the market next season. Look how it oozes in and out of your fingers. In and out of your fingers. It is beautiful. And it's completely harmless if swallowed, and it doesn't stain clothes.
It's quite a breakthrough.
You have to run now?
Well, I'm sure you have a lot of work you have to do.
Yeah. Don't worry about that.
About what?
Mr. Woodman. I'll call him. I'll explain the whole situation.
Oh, sure. Right. Well, I'm sure he's not going to have any trouble renting that place.
Oh, no.
It's a lovely place.
Oh, sure. The loft. Stone fireplace.
Yeah.
It's hard to resist.
I know.
Yes. Oh, what is it?
Captain, excuse me, Mrs. Miller.
It's all right.
I don't think we've ever really been introduced. I'm Arthur Dietrich.
Oh, how do you do, Arthur?
Of course, the captain's told us a lot.
What is it, Dietrich?
We'll talk later. I got a lead from the owner of the toy company. It may be a case of industrial espionage.
Uh-huh, yeah. All right, check it out.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry for the interruption.
No, it's okay.
Okay. I'm going now.
Yeah, fine.
I'll be out of here in a second. I'm gone.
You... pardon me. Hey! I want out!
Hold it down, Cummings.
I want out of here!
I'm gonna put the cuffs on.
Let me out!
What's going on here?
Please, I'm suffocating! I'm... Mommy! Daddy!
I think you have your hands full.
Let me out!
We'll talk later. Goodbye, everybody. It's nice to see you.
Let me out!
Sir, what should I do?
Let him out!
That makes sense.
Who's that?
It's Mr. Medderling, the father of Ooze.
Ah, yes. Mr. Medderling. I'm Captain Miller. I'd just like to say that we're going to do everything we can to clear this up.
Oh, sure. That's what they told me last year when they stole my sludge.
Sludge?
It's not a pretty story.
In my office.
Oh, Bart. It was really great to see Liz. It's too bad she couldn't stay longer.
Well, we just had some checks to go over and Christmas plans to finalize, you know. Ah.
Big turkey dinner with the family, huh?
No, just Christmas morning with the kids.
Oh. You're not gonna stay for dinner?
This is all very silly and stupid.
Here's the rent.
Oh, Berman! So you thought you could get away with it, huh?
My lawyer will be contacting your lawyer.
Dietrich?
This is Nathan Berman, owner of the Berman Novelty Company.
Mr. Berman, I'm Captain Miller.
I am completely innocent of anything.
First, you stole my sludge, you know.
Oh, you're all crazy. Whoa, gentlemen, please.
He's talking gibberish, Captain. I know him for 35 years, and he is no longer completely with us.
Oh, listen, Berman,
please. Mr. Berman, we're investigating a burglary, and our information has it that... you might be able to shed some light on it.
I am a law-abiding merchant. Now, who would want to accuse me of anything like that?
I never said a word, Mr. Berman.
You're not going to take the word of that cheap hoodlum.